The following is a presentation of HBO Sports.
I'd love.
It's good. It's joint.
Yeah?
He's not here.
Really?
We'll see if he's in the room.
How come I just found out about it?
I just found out as well. I've been trying to call him. Nothing. So I'm going to go.
Okay.
See if he's overslept or what happened. I'm going to take care of it to see if he's overslept or...
Yeah, go find him fast, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. He worked out.
Yeah.
He lifted him. You don't just miss the walk. Sometimes he might be on a fucking plane back and forth.
Was that 20 with that? With the backpack on?
What's up, buddy?
Tell me you overslept. We gotta talk after this thing?
Last week, defensive back LaMarcus Joyner, number 20, refused to practice.
You ain't gonna win?
Eventually, he did return to action. But this week, he's still conflicted, even willing to walk away from his $1.25 million a year salary.
Good. Thanks. Close, please. All right. Take the backpack off. You got some water? Sorry. Do you want me to start or you want to start? Because I'm here to help. I don't know, because I don't know where my passion goes. Yeah. I work hard. You know, I do want to be a starter for this team. What's going on? Like, if y'all don't need me, let me know. And just release me. Y'all can have y'all money back. That's what I told them. I say, I don't play football for money. I say, all these guys, they've been locker room. It's about money. It's about girls. It's about cars. Coach, I love this game. I can go work at Walmart. I don't need these people money. But while I'm here, I'm not going to waste y'all time with the way I work and what I put into it. So why would I want another man to waste my time?
Mm-hmm.
Like, what's my role? Be honest with me. The nickel spot. Inside. It's the hardest position to play. It's harder than outside. It's hard. It's the hardest position to play. Okay? You're the best that I've had here in years inside. It's a starting position. Okay. No, I don't really know, Coach. Huh? I don't know. You don't know? I'm going to tell you a story. You know Steve McNair, right?
Okay.
We're playing Kansas City. He takes a shot in the chest. And so we're going to put him in the hospital. And then I go over to see Steve at the hospital. Steve tells me he can't do it anymore. He can't play. He's lost the passion. It's not fun. And he's gonna quit. So we get to Sunday, and he says he's okay with being a two. In the Pittsburgh game, my starting quarterback, backup, gets shit knocked out of him. And we're down by four with less than 2 minutes left to go. And I turn at Steve and I look at him, and he winked at me, went on the field, four play drive, we were in the end zone. And we beat him. I realized he had the passion. I had to capture it and get it back. I want LaMarcus back. I want your passion. I gotta pull it back out of you.
I trust you, Coach. I swear to God I do.
Yeah.
Because I know in your heart you're a good man. Like, I know that for a fact.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, now that I'm seeing a bigger picture hanging from you, I'm gonna walk out here with a clear conscience, no matter what happens.
The final week of camp is always complicated, partly owing to its dual nature. For most of the team, it's a doorway to the regular season opener against the 49ers. But for players on the edge of the roster, this week is a gut-churning trial. Because in a matter of days, 22 players will be cut and walk out the door for good. Defensive lineman Ethan Westbrooks is one of the players still trying to find favor with the coaching staff.
You get your fucking eyes lower. End of story. I ain't saying it one more fucking time. You see this shit right here? Fuck this shit, Ethan. I'm sick of fucking saying it. I'm sick of fucking watching it. I had to write that last thing. Get your fucking eyes lower or you're playing someplace else.
I don't ever put that out of my mind that I could be cut. And Wolf definitely reminds us.
Do you really
want to
do this shit?
Yes, sir.
Do you really
want to
do this for
good?
Yes, sir.
I got three babies back home, man. A mom and sisters, and, you know, plenty of people in my circle that I definitely want to do better for.
You're capable of 20 times more than what you're doing. It's like, yeah, it's like Mike Tyson. In a ring, Mike Tyson couldn't mess around with because he had a gift like you had, that power. That power.
Mike Tyson, I'm not there, so.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He had that power. That was the difference. Okay.
Right.
Any difference can make or break a player on the bubble. Number 53 linebacker Brandon Chubb has enormous heart. But for the undrafted rookie, that might not be enough.
I love the Chubb kid. I think he's a tough son of a bitch. He's smart, and he'll get at you. But is it enough? He's still got to understand how to operate in the middle of the defense.
Come on, Chubb.
I mean, right after this game, next 2 days they're making cuts, so you don't want to leave any bad impressions or any doubts in their minds, and that's what I'm trying to do in this game. And in each game, I approach the same way, so just trying to do better.
You're too high now, Chubb. You're too high. Got no power.
You gotta do that.
Yes, sir.
You wanna make this team tell me you gotta do that.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
The other guy Chubb should be learning from is number 52, Alec Ogletree. He's not only the Rams' starting middle linebacker, but a pretty good father figure.
You all right with Adam?
Yeah, but he's gonna want another one. My dad's like, you guys are so worried about Alton. Just feed the boy.
Yeah, but just pour it up. Just spit it out if you don't want it.
Look how he's looking.
You going home?
Going home.
You gonna leave me?
No way.
That's all right. I'm ready to go home too. You'll be good.
Dad has to go.
Yeah. I love you. Bye, man.
For veteran defensive linemen Robert Quinn and Will Hayes, roster spots are a sure thing. A hot lunch? Maybe not.
Hey, this one on right here. There we go. That just shows, like, I'm the brains of this whole operation.
What operation?
This whole D-line thing. That's my guy, baby. She supports the mermaid.
It says mermaid vibes. For Uncle Will.
Will's her godfather, so
we got her. We keep her updated with the mermaids and mermaid vibes.
The Rams have returned home from St. Louis after 20 years of back in L.A.
They're the subject of a new season of Hard Knocks on HBO,
where we get to know players like Rams defensive end William Hayes.
Okay, Jim.
Hayes looks good on the field, but the old man
looks a little chunky right there.
Has revealed some startling beliefs.
Will Hayes absolutely loves and is totally convinced that there are mermaids, they do exist.
One thing he does not believe in is dinosaurs.
I just think some to be completely honest with you. Venom with T-Rex walking around here, you know, something that man ain't never seen. Easter Bunny and all that. So, you know, they call me something.
I think I have a new favorite football player.
They get you on the show now.
Hey, I would like to take him on a field trip to the Museum of
Animals. I'd like to take Jimmy out there too, man.
Maybe get him his own show on Animal Planet or something.
Last week, Tavon Austin received a $42 million contract extension. But while he's on a roll, rookie receiver Nelson Spruce is still nursing a bum wheel he sustained in the Rams' preseason win 3 weeks ago.
I think I had a pretty good start in my first preseason game, but that looks like it's going to be the only opportunity I'm going to have to show what I have. I mean, that's just kind of how football goes. It's frustrating, but, you know, I'm just trying to take it a day at a time.
With Spruce in the trainer's room, free agent wide receiver Austin Hill, number 9, and Paul McRoberts, number 8, are getting more reps. That means more chances to earn a roster spot.
There it is, right there. That's a good rep. There you go, Paul.
They're both up and down, and both were all players for different reasons. I think Paul has got the ball skills. He's more instinctive as a route runner. He just kind of feels the space.
Here we go. You got it, Austin.
Austin, he had energy out there. This kid's sharp. He knows what to do. Just a little bit limited physically. They're both similar in the fact that they can do it right one day, and then have the same thing happen the next day and do it wrong.
My rhyme bomb, cause I go to the limit. I climb from the gut and I fall to the finish. If I'm willing to be giving all I got a lot more money. You can think that I'm at a flat floor. Got a flat floor to expose my demons. Don't look directly in my eyes when I forget everything, cause you could take it on. And that's not right. You don't wanna feel these feelings. I fight shine like drip drop acid in the sun. I line with God like when I'm number one. I hit the gym to work out my wingspan. I push up, I pull up, I get it in, man.
You're not going to see anybody make that play like he did that right there.
Who was that? Was that Marcus?
Holy shit. He took this away, took that, and then he, yeah.
Wanna go cut Mr. Kush?
I love the red hair.
I love your blonde hair, by the way.
And boys have white hair.
Oh, yeah. Y'all have any more babies?
I think we're done at two. Our five-year-old, you know, back when he was 2 and a half, you know, he was potty trained and...
Right.
And we're like, okay, this isn't bad. Let's have another one. And then we did. You go straight back to diapers. Uh-huh. You stand up all night, you're like, oh, man.
Great. It's hard being away from the family.
Oh, yeah.
Eric Kush, number 60, is battling for a roster spot with David Arkin, number 66.
Kush was better at guard than he was at center. He's playing stronger, and he's playing more confident. I think Arkin can play guard and center. This guy's smart.
All right, so who's our backup center right now? Arkin or Kush?
Both of those two guys would have to compete for the job.
Did you like Joe Montana when you were a kid?
Oh, yeah.
Man, you watch this line. Man, you do a lot of things like him, man.
Sorry?
You do a lot of things like him. You really do. I mean, I got to watch him play in practice the whole time. I used to go watch him all the time.
He's pretty good.
Yeah, he's pretty good, yeah. He's pretty good. I just wonder when I saw the 16, I was going, you probably are.
That's why I've worn it.
Jared Goff isn't the starting quarterback. That role belongs to number 17, Case Keenum. Fact is, Goff has some work to do to beat out Sean Mannion, number 14, for the second string job.
Sean really, I think, has had an outstanding camp. You know, I liked him as a rookie, but he's that much better now, in my opinion. I feel comfortable having to put 14 in the ballgame. Next would be Jared. I think the kid's made great strides. I believe reps are his best friend. He has the mental capacity, and I think as he continues to get more reps, it will help him.
Okay, who's two against the 49ers?
Tonight we're in the Twin Cities, the Rams and the Vikings in the exhibition finale from U.S. Bank Stadium.
Well, get him up, Dad. Drew's about to get his thing signed after the game.
He bought himself a jersey.
What's wrong with buying another man's jersey, bro? See, that's what's wrong with y'all. People got too much pride these days.
Let's go! Huh? Yeah! You alright? Come on! Shit! Hey, let's go compete, man! Let's go! You guys are going, go! Shit! Go have fun! Let's go! Let's go! One, three! One, two, three! Win! Let's go, boys!
Let's go! Let's go, baby!
How much do you want to make this team? How much do you want to be a part of the Los Angeles Rams? You have to show it today!
Great day, baby. Don't let nothing hold you back here. I'm having fun with this shit.
All right, Jared, let's have a little fun. Drive these guys now, right? Peace. One play at a time.
Hey, one here.
Bob takes a clean snap on Reed, right side. It's caught by Reynolds. He shakes the first tackler at the 50. Down the near sideline into the Vikings territory. Dodging the shotgun. Picks the hit off to the right. He's got room to run. Goes up and fires. It's complete. At the 20, Bradley Martinez scores.
Days after his meeting with Jeff Fisher, LaMarcus Joyner is eager to prove that his coach's faith in him is justified.
LaMarcus Joyner is a very special player. To be able to cover a guy all the way across field, he was on the receiver step for step.
Ethan Westbrooks needs to impress tonight. The defensive lineman who once had his coach throw paper in his face is still on shaky ground.
Third and 12th. The Vikings behind the chains with 5:23 to go and trailing 7-0. Straight back top. Wanted to throw the screen left. Now rolls to his right.
Get it. Come on, Ethan!
It is caught by tiptoeing Jarius Wright. Ethan Westbrook's the left defensive end. Came inside. He has to stay outside to contain the quarterback.
In preseason game number 4, any mistake could cost you a job.
What are you doing?
That's right.
No. Yeah, but stay outside. Listen. Fuck. Why would you come back underneath? Listen to me. What else did we talk about doing?
The pound? Then fucking do it.
Come on. That's a fucking sack. It would come right through you. Come on.
Jared Goff was the number one pick in this year's draft. For the Rams, that makes him a potential franchise player. For the rest of the league, it just makes him a target.
Oh, fuck. He got hit again. Get me!
Third down, 7.
Yeah, I get 40. Hey, thanks, too. That's me.
That's me. Brandon, can you hear me?
All right.
Brandon Chubb is a rookie linebacker on the bubble. Tonight, he gets a chance to prove his worth. He'll get more defensive snaps than any other player on the team.
He's out there trying to prove he needs to be on this roster.
Breaks away from the tackle. Actually dives to the fourth pylon. And he goes in for six. Darrell Preston gives the Vikings their first lead tonight.
We're going to take a deep breath. Okay? Take a deep breath. Have they done anything to stop us? Has it been us? It's about us. So focus on what we can control.
It's 70-something and they cut it down to 53. So there's like 20-some-odd people that are going to get.
Okay.
You need to cut it.
Chanelle Seau is hoping her brother Ian isn't one of them. Number 72 has speed, but lacks power.
A gaping hole up the left hash mark. He's out across the 30. Pick up a 13 yards.
Vikings
trying to extend a 20-10 lead. He turns, he gives it to Hand, and he plunges in.
I appreciate it, man. I mean, I know I didn't do that much today, but I still would like to sit down.
This is what y'all wanted, right? You wanted to play under the big lights, big stage. All right, it's time to show up.
Let's go, baby!
It's the last chance for two receivers competing for a single roster spot. Paul McRoberts, number 8. And Austin Hill, number 9.
Austin Hill, we've been wanting to see you out there and make plays.
Once again, it's the dual nature of the week. Fierce competition tempered by mutual respect. hitting the sections, you've got to do something to catch the coach's eye.
That's some fun out there, baby.
Get it.
Hey, and if you got some room on this damn foot return, you could have...
I know how I am, bro.
Come on, Paul. Come on, Paul. Break one, young man.
Deep to receive for the Rams.
Paul McRoberts nor Austin Hill has much time left to make a play that might make a difference.
Hey, forget about it. Next play. Right? We talked about it. Next play.
You got it, bro. You can't do no worse than me, bro. You hear me? So just take that shit off and go. You hear me? Trust me, bro. Right now, it's the time. I'm letting that shit go, too, bro. So this is where we get our money at.
Hey, I'm just gonna call it and run it. No overthinking it, no fucking Andre and Louie and roll. Watch your fucking dick on it.
Party in the end zone, man.
Party in the fucking end zone.
Hey,
wait for us.
Huh? Y'all gonna come?
Will you wait for
y'all
us before you run
y'all
off?
Come to our party?
Alright, well, come to this.
Come to the party, baby. Let's go.
Here's third and goal from the two.
Fades, kill, true dive. Hey, let's get in the end zone. Hey, we got Fades, kill, true dive. Ready?
Good job right there. Tell him that. I know everybody will.
The Rams still trail by 9, and center Eric Kush, number 60, is pushing for all he's worth.
They hand off to Green. Left tackle run. He's got a lane. Down the near sideline and in for another Los Angeles touchdown.
Yeah, bitch! Yes! That's a fucking touchdown!
Eric Kush doing a great job leading that 26-yard touchdown run. So 27-25, no timeout. Sean Mannion leads the offense back onto the field.
All right, so he knows we've got no timeouts.
Finish this shit. We're going to block our asses off. You run the fuck out of these routes. Let's go.
This is what pros live for. Game on the line, seconds to play. The perfect opportunity to not just win this game, but a place on the final roster.
Here we go. The Rams have 40 seconds left in the preseason. A field goal will win it. It is in the shotgun. Pulling for the snap and push. Michael, put the pressure.
It is a quarterback's nightmare to see the front of his offensive line as jersey.
Yeah, because he's turning back looking at him. Like, oh, yeah. Oops. That's my man.
Awesome. Nice to meet you, man.
Nice to meet you, too, bro.
Hello.
Cutdown day is coming up on Saturday. Rams have to be down to 53. They have 22 names to announce.
Now we wait to see what the fuck's going to happen to us.
You guys in the second half, you guys sucked it up. That's a hell of a job. That was a hell of a job for you guys, you know? I'm proud of you. That's not easy. That's a hell of a job. That's the nature of the fourth preseason game. Tomorrow's going to be a tough day, okay? We all know that. It's going to be a rough day.
Do you have enough confidence that if something were to happen to your starter that he would be the guy that would be the backup?
I think it's going to take a little bit more time, but that doesn't mean to say he can't be a two. But if we were starting right now, I'd probably have Sean as a two.
The Rams are dismantling camp at UC Irvine and heading up the coast to Thousand Oaks, their headquarters for the regular season. It's moving day. More important, it's cutdown day. For 22 men, this may be the end of a lifelong dream.
Okay. How you doing?
Yeah.
Good so far. How was it feel for you?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Yep.
Here we go, we're in there. We're gonna go see Coach.
Yeah.
We'll go over this way.
Take you two fellows over to see Coach. Okay.
Morgan.
Yeah.
It's not all good.
Not all good?
We're going to go see Coach.
That's cool.
Okay.
We're
going to have to stop you there, big fella.
Oh, okay.
You're going to go see Coach.
Gosh.
Okay.
Brandon, would you come with me, please? Coach would like to see you.
From Rock Gullickson's weight room, it's a short walk to learn whether you've been cut outright or managed to make the practice squad. Not exactly a roster spot, but a $7,000 a week consolation prize.
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
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 All right. Good news, bad news.
All we want to do is get your practice squad.
Okay.
And that's good news.
You showed us everything that we need to see. So we got guys who are practice squad guys who come up to the roster and go play and do
right.
But it's just a way that we can take care of our own.
Right.
It's a good thing to be excited
about. Yes, sir. I am.
Okay, congratulations, Jeff.
Thank you.
Uncle works out. I'll see you in a couple days.
There's no fudging the numbers. The Rams have 10 defensive linemen, but will only keep 9. Somebody has to go.
Hey, Bruce. Are you taking me to see Coach? No.
If everybody ever knew, you'd be taking me, Coach.
No, not happening. Not happening. Ian Coach needs to see you.
Defensive lineman Ian Seau, the nephew of Hall of Famer Junior Seau, is the next to learn his fate.
doing, Jensen? You feeling all right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Well, this is that day, you know?
Yeah.
Good thing, sir.
Right now, you don't make our active roster. I think you should keep trying. Because you're in a rush, you know? You just need strength. You need something to get stronger.
Yeah.
We'll see what happens.
Sure, sure.
You know?
Yep.
Okay. Enjoyed having you, man.
Sweet.
That's good. There's Waffles downstairs. I know he wants to talk to you.
Huh? He just wants to wish you. Wants to shake your hand. All right, buddy. Good luck.
Do you still want to play in this league?
Mm-hmm.
That's the answer to the test.
Yeah.
Now, this is a tough room to break the ice into, as you know, okay? But with the experience that you have right now, you need to get stronger, Ian, okay? You need to get more physically stronger, and because you have rush ability. Your get-off and your ability to come around that corner is special. We're going to miss you, man. You're a great person. Your uncle will be proud of you, man. So you did a lot of good things, and, you know, you made it this far. That's a lot of guys didn't, you know, so that's good. All right?
Yep.
All right, good luck, Ian. All right, man. That's it. All right, brother.
Obviously, it sucks right now, but it's the business and the whole entire league, so a lot of people got cut. My next step, man, is to simply get back into the gym, start working. I know I can play at this level. They know I can play at this level. Hopefully, other teams say I can play at this level. You know, I'm going to have another opportunity somewhere. Just got to capitalize on it.
How we doing, guys? Yeah? Getting it going? Chris, are you all right? Greg? Either I ran out of paper or ink, but your name's not on my list.
All right.
This is bad.
Yeah.
What's up, big boy?
What's up, Coach?
How you doing? Sucks, man. Sit down. I'll tell you the best that I can put it to you.
Yeah.
I've been through it before. You gotta play your ass off all preseason. I can't keep everybody.
Yeah.
I can't. You know, it's hard. It's hard to save us.
Yeah.
You know, love having you around, man. I don't know how to comfort you other than you played your ass off. You got a great body of work in the preseason.
Mm-hmm.
A great body of work. A versatility center guard.
Yeah.
You know, sorry, but someone would probably claim you.
Yeah.
Okay. And then you end up on the roster. Yeah. This is one I wasn't looking forward to, but I want you to walk out with your chin up, smile on your face, and You know, the next chapter will open for you.
Appreciate
give your wife my best, and we had a lot of fun.
Yeah,
taking out those little rascals.
It was fun here.
I know. It's
had
fun.
A blast.
It was fun. That was fun.
Huh?
That was fun. I'm gonna miss it. Go see you again.
Absolutely.
Okay.
You hanging in? This is a tough one, huh?
It's a tough one.
No, you've been through it probably too many times. Feel like you got something on your mind?
No. Just I thought I played pretty well. You know, I was excited about how I played and everything. So I just had a lot of fun here.
Yeah.
I had a lot of fun here. And that's what hurts the most.
Yeah, it's just tough. And you played well.
Mm-hmm.
So I can understand why it's tough.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That one I can't. There's nothing I can say that's going to make that feel.
Mm-hmm.
You know? But you're always a call away.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know what I mean? And if anybody calls, I'll help you out.
Cool.
You did what you fought, played well, and you gotten better. Tough one.
Yeah. Yep. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
it sucks, man. You know, packing up all my things up.
Don't look at me, guys.
But it's part of the business, part of the journey, you know. You just have fun along the way. You know, enjoy the experience, enjoy the guys you meet. You know, some of these guys are going to be lifelong friends. It's tough, man. Okay, go back home and just wait for phone call, see what's gonna happen next, see where I'm going next. But it's part of the business, part of the journey, you know. Try to get as many years as I can out of this thing.
He may get another. The Chicago Bears sign him almost immediately. They are Kush's sixth team in the last two seasons.
You okay?
Not really.
Sucks?
We need to go see Coach.
Yeah.
Okay?
So we'll
go there right now. Okay?
There's no more nerve-wracking walk in the NFL. For Paul McRoberts, there's no way to know if he's getting his dream job or getting cut.
How you doing?
Amazing.
Good. Amazing. Good. Sit down. Let's talk. Here's what we got going. This is good news, bad news, kind of thing.
Yeah. We're going to keep you around.
Okay. And our intention is to get you on practice squad. Okay.
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
So you came a long way.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. How's things at home?
Yeah, right. Pretty good.
Mom's doing good.
Yeah,
everybody hanging?
Great.
Yeah.
Hanging in there.
All
definitely.
Right, man. So you can tell Mom you're on our practice squad.
Okay.
With a smile on your face.
Definitely. Always keep this in mind.
Okay.
Yeah, and I'm gonna teach you. I'll teach you how to kiss puzzle. You can have
them,
huh?
Definitely.
Yeah.
I only did it 2 weeks of my last scene.
Yeah.
Something.
Yeah. That's
okay.
You can do it.
I'm not
biased. It's just all decisions. You make decision. You make decision and live with it. I just gotta teach you how to make a decision.
Definitely.
Just have him left.
Yeah, he should be here.
Is he home?
Yeah, I marked him up. He was here.
Austin Hill's journey has been a steep climb since he signed as a free agent. The question now, did he do enough to earn a spot on the practice squad?
What's up, buddy? I'm doing good.
How you doing?
Go ahead, grab a seat.
This is that day, you know?
Yeah.
Loved having you, you know? I thought you did great, you know? Coming as late as you did, learned offense, made plays, so.
Yeah.
It was a fun experience.
Yeah, no, I definitely got on quick, you know.
I hope you enjoyed it.
Yeah, no, it was fun.
You got body work on tape, you know, for other clubs, stuff like that. If somebody calls, I'll give you a great recommendation. You got it?
Got
it.
Shoot straight with you, man. I appreciate it. Love having you, kid.
Okay.
Thank you, everything.
Take care of those girls. Okay.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Austin Hill has been cut.
Think that it's gonna be like easier each time, but it's really not. It's a job that I really wanna be able to have, and it's just hard getting in. I'm just hoping that I'll get the chance to prove myself one day. So I'll stay ready. I'll just stay ready.
The cuts are finished. Players once on the bubble can now exhale.
It's like opening up a new book to a new chapter in your life. You know, you get to write your own story.
I don't even know what to expect, to be honest. I leave it up in God's hands, but you could definitely expect it to be some quarterback sacks.
You always want to keep it in your mind that you hustle hard to get here, and you want to keep on hustling to get somewhere better than where you're at right now.
I was surprised Coach got cut. Did anybody else get cut today? Did you talk to Nelson this morning?
I saw my treatment.
Think it's official?
I think so. They said 1 o'clock. Today's the deadline, but...
1:30.
Hope so.
Yeah.
It should be all right.
Paul got peace quality. That's cool.
I know.
It's been a really good progression, and you know, I'm happy with the strides I've made so far. And there's obviously stuff, you know, I'd like to have done better in preseason and in camp. But, you know, there's a lot of stuff. There's probably more things that I'm happy with that I did that, you know, I'm able to build on. And, again, you know, it's whenever I'm ready, whenever that is. I don't know. It's up to them. But I feel like I'm getting closer to being ready every day.
It was a long camp, but it went by really fast, you know?
I'm glad it's over, though, that's for sure.
It's over, too.
Whoa.
Watch, there's a big cliff there.
There is a big cliff there.
Yeah, wait. It is crazy that we're here.
It is.
We're in L.A.
It's going to be fun to play the first game.
It's going to be fun to play the whole season.
It is. I'm excited to watch.
It's the Hustle Boulevard, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Destiny's Child. Ooh, okay, Beyonce. Kelly.
Entertainment capital of the world.
Right. Oh, Mike.
We're going to be here. Yeah.
Mike, Jackson. You got a bunch of move for me.
Jack Sparrow.
Okay. Hey.
Ooh.
Okay.
Hey, you got to tip him after that. You're supposed to tip him.
that's what they're doing. Yeah.
Spidey. Looking a little skinny there.
Can you take a picture, please?
Yeah. Yeah, no problem. Do you know who this is?
Know who that is?
This is Chris Rock. Now's when it really counts. So we put in a lot of work, you know, through camp. Camp felt really long. And now it's, you know, the games actually matter now, so I think everyone's really excited.
Am I an instrument?
No.
I'm not an animal or an insect?
Nope.
And I'm not a food?
Nope.
And I'm not furniture?
Nope.
But you're earning
that time.
What? Am I a...
Regina?
I don't know.
Gosh. For Riley,
I get hard ones.
Okay.
You know, we don't really know what's going to happen next, and it's like just the limbo that we've kind of been like in the last few years. It's just kind of like, okay, we got a call. I think we're going to be here. Nope. Back to limbo. Like, now we don't know. You kind of have to find the balance, and it's just really hard to. You know, Ryland's lucky. She's still young. She doesn't really understand all of it. I know it'd be a lot harder to be doing this if she was older. That's for sure. Ooh. You cheated, huh? You saw it.
Did you see it? Okay.
Am I yellow?
You can be multiple colors.
Am I yellow?
Yeah, you can be. Yeah, you can be yellow.
Yellow, green, or blue?
Mm-hmm.
Are you sure you didn't look?
Am I blue?
You're such a cheat. You are such a cheat. Why do you do that?
That's not how you play. I don't know if it's because we're used to it, but that's what we do. We always like say like, this is a roller coaster, this is a roller coaster, which they're super fun, but then like sometimes make you nauseous and kind of scary.
Yeah.
But it's an experience.
Hi, Mom and Dad. Hi.
Easy.
Good job.
just gonna keep growing and become a strong family. I'm just trying to find a place and find a home so that I can finally be able to provide for them.
Okay, baby girl?
This thing's, like, unprecedented, what you guys have been through. It was almost as if it was a first training camp for us. But you guys just worked. And what you did is commendable. It's going to take us a long way. But now we're done, okay? We're out of here. Be careful driving north. Traffic's what it is. You're going to have to deal with it. And on your way up there, think about beating the Niners on Monday night. That's what we got to do. That's where our minds are right now. I will see you on 405 North here in about 15 minutes. So let's go.
Okay.
Training camp is over, but the Rams' journey isn't. 6 months ago, they moved half a continent away, and they're moving still, searching for their new California identity.
The rest of the league doesn't care. The rest of the league has no idea what we've been through, and it doesn't matter. It's been a whirlwind. And now everything's just kind of moved on and we're here.
They spent the summer working to get better, building an under-the-radar roster bolstered by some gems. The Rams aren't expecting miracles in the City of Angels. But they know that in Hollywood, happy endings happen all the time.
Margaret?
Can I touch it?
Oh, so soft.
This thing, no!
Who's the best running back? Who's taking over on offense already? Look, you're
back. Are you there?
I guess that's what having children to do to you.
I can direct hard enough. Later on, I've got to need help.
That actually was messed up. You got Profiles Tavon playing Pokemon Go. Tavon doesn't know shit about Pokemon.
Make sure if a camera guy's in the way,
they
just knock the hell out of them.
Here we go. We're going to present the same problems for our opponents.
Sorry.
It's okay.
That's some 7-9 bullshit.
That's some 7-9 fucking bullshit.
September 10th, middleweight champ Gennady Golovkin defends his title against welterweight champ Kell Brook. Later that night, tune in for a replay of that fight, along with live boxing headlined by Chocolatito Gonzalez against Carlos Cuadras. One week later, Canelo Alvarez returns to the 154-pound division, taking on title holder Liam Smith, only on HBO pay-per-view. Presentation of HBO Sports.
Love.
Yeah?
Really?
So how come I just found out about it?
I just found out as well. I've been trying to call him. Nothing. So I'm
okay.
See if he's overslept or what happened. I'm going to take care of it to see if he's overslept or...
Yeah, they'll find him fast, yeah.
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 He would have.
Yeah.
He left it. You don't just miss the walk. Sometimes he might be on a fucking plane back and forth.
Was that 20 with that? With a backpack on? What's up, buddy? Tell me you overslept. Are you, we gonna talk after this thing?
Last week, defensive back LaMarcus Joyner, number 20, refused to practice.
You ain't gonna win?
Eventually, he did return to action. But this week, he's still conflicted. Even willing to walk away from his $1.25 million a year salary.
Good. Thanks. Close, please. All right. Take your backpack off. You got some water?
Sorry. Do you want me to start or you want to start? Because I'm here to help.
I don't know, Coach. I don't know where my passion is.
Yeah.
I work hard. You know, I do want to be a starter for this team. What's going on? Like, if y'all don't need me, let me know. And just release me. Y'all can have y'all money back. That's what I told them. I say, I don't play football for money. I say, all these guys, they been locker room. It's about money. It's about girls. It's about cars. Coach, I love this game. I can go work at Walmart. I don't need these people money. But while I'm here, I'm not going to waste y'all time with the way I work and what I put into it. So why would I want another man to waste my time?
Mm-hmm.
Like, what's my role? Be honest with me.
The nickel spot. Inside. It's the hardest position to play. It's harder than outside. It's hard. It's the hardest position to play. Okay? You're the best that I've had here in years inside. It's a starting position. Okay.
You know, I don't really know, Coach.
Huh?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I'm just...
I'm going to tell you a story. You know Steve McNair, right?
Okay.
We're playing Kansas City. He takes a shot in the chest. And so we're going to put him in the hospital. And then I go over to see Steve at the hospital. Steve tells me he can't do it anymore. He can't play. He's lost the passion. It's not fun. And he's gonna quit. So we get to Sunday, and he says he's okay with being a two. In the Pittsburgh game, my starting quarterback, backup, gets shit knocked out of him. And we're down by four with less than 2 minutes left to go. And I turn at Steve, and I look at him, and he winked at me, went on the field. Four play drive, we were in the end zone. And we beat him. Well, I realized he had the passion. I had to capture it and get it back. I want LaMarcus back. I want your passion. I gotta pull it back out of you. I
trust you, Coach. I swear to God I do.
Yeah.
Because I know in your heart you're a good man. Like, I know that for a fact.
Yeah.
I mean, now that I'm seeing a bigger picture hanging from you, I'm going to walk out here with a clear conscience no matter what happens.
Yeah. Just play some ball. Jerry Ball has to play some ball.
I'm good, Coach.
I know you're
playing some football, man.
Hmm?
I'm always ready to play football.
I know you are, but that's what I'm...
That's what you do best, huh?
You do best.
Appreciate it. All right.
The final week of camp is always complicated, partly owing to its dual nature. For most of the team, it's a doorway to the regular season opener against the 49ers. But for players on the edge of the roster, this week is a gut-churning trial. Because in a matter of days, 22 players will be cut and walk out the door for good. Defensive lineman Ethan Westbrooks is one of the players still trying to find favor with the coaching staff.
You get your fucking eyes lower. End of story. I ain't saying it one more fucking time. You see this shit right here? Fuck this shit, Ethan. I'm sick of fucking saying it. I'm sick of fucking watching it. I had to write that last thing. Get your fucking eyes lower or you're playing someplace else.
I don't ever put that out of my mind that I could be cut. And Wolf definitely reminds us.
Do you really
want to
do this shit?
Yes, sir.
Huh? Do you really
want to
do this for
quick?
Yes, sir.
I got three babies back home, man. A mom and sisters, and, you know, plenty of people in my circle that I definitely want to do better for.
You're capable of 20 times more than what you're doing. It's like, yeah, it's like Mike Tyson in the ring. Mike Tyson couldn't mess around with because he had a gift like you had, that power. That power.
Tyson and not there, so.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He had that power. That was the difference. Okay.
Right.
Any difference can make or break a player on the bubble. Number 53 linebacker Brandon Chubb has enormous heart. But for the undrafted rookie, that might not be enough.
Play by your rules.
I love the Chubb kid. I think he's a tough son of a bitch. He's smart, and he'll get at you. But is it enough? He still got to understand how to operate in the middle of the defense.
Come on, Chubb.
I mean, right after this game, next 2 days they're making cuts, so you don't want to leave any bad impressions or any doubts in their minds, and that's what I'm trying to do in this game. And in each game, I approach the same way, so just trying to do better.
You're too high now, Chubb. You're too high. Got no power.
The other guy Chubb should be learning from is number 52, Alec Ogletree. He's not only the Rams' starting middle linebacker, but a pretty good father figure.
Y'all already fed him?
Yeah, but he's gonna want another one. My dad's like, you guys are so worried about ounces. Just feed the boy.
Yeah, but just pour it up. Just spit it out if you don't want it.
Look how he's looking.
You going home?
Going home.
You gonna leave me?
No way.
That's all right. I'm gonna go home too. You'll be good.
Dad has to go.
Yeah. I love you. Bye, man.
For veteran defensive linemen Robert Quinn and Will Hayes, roster spots are a sure thing. A hot lunch? Maybe not.
Hey, this one on right here. There we go. That just shows, like, I'm the brains of this whole operation.
What operation?
This whole D-line thing. That's my guy, baby. She supports the mermaid.
It says mermaid vibes. For Uncle Will. Will's her godfather, so we got her. We keep her updated with the mermaids and mermaid vibes.
The Rams have returned home from St. Louis after 20 years. They're back in L.A.
They were the subject of a new season of Hard Knocks on HBO,
where we get to know players like Rams defensive end William Hayes.
Okay, James.
Hayes looks good on the field, but the old man
looks a little chunky out there.
Has revealed some startling beliefs.
Will Hayes absolutely is totally convinced that there are mermaids. They do exist.
One thing he does not believe in is dinosaurs.
I just think some. To be completely honest with you, fed him a T-Rex walking around here. You know, something man ain't never seen. Easter Bunny and all that. So, you know, they're on the same.
I think I have a new favorite football player.
They get you on the show now.
Hey, I would like to take him on a field trip to the Museum of
Animals. I'd like to take Jimmy out there too, man.
Maybe get him his own show on Animal Planet or something.
Last week, Tavon Austin received a $42 million contract extension. But while he's on a roll, rookie receiver Nelson Spruce is still nursing a bum wheel he sustained in the Rams' preseason win 3 weeks ago.
I think I had a pretty good start in my first preseason game, but that looks like it's going to be the only opportunity I'm going to have to show what I have. I mean, that's just kind of how football goes. It's frustrating, but, you know, I'm just trying to take it a day at a time.
With Spruce in the trainer's room, free agent wide receiver Austin Hill, number 9, and Paul McRoberts, number 8, are getting more reps. That means more chances to earn a roster spot.
There it is, right there. That's a good rep.
There you go, Paul.
They're both up and down, and both raw players for different reasons. I think Paul has got the ball skills. He's more instinctive as a route runner. He just kind of feels the space.
Here we go. You got it, Austin.
Austin, he had energy out there. This kid's sharp. He knows what to do. Just a little bit limited physically. They're both similar in the fact that they can do it right one day, and then have the same thing happen the next day and do it wrong.
My bound, cause I go to the limit. I grind from the gut and I flow to the finish. If I'm money, I'm giving all I got. I got a lot more money. If you think that I'm at a platform, got a platform to expose my feelings. Don't look directly in my eyes when I forget everything that you could take it on. And that's not right. You don't wanna feel these feelings. I fight shine like drip drop acid in the sun. I line with God like I'm number one. I hit the gym to work out my wingspan. I push up, I pull up, I get it in, man.
You're not gonna see anybody make that play like he did that right there.
Who was that? Was that Marcus?
Holy shit. He took this away, took that, and then he, yeah.
I wanna go cut Mr. Kush.
I love your blonde hair, by the way.
And boys have white hair.
Oh, yeah. You don't have any more babies?
I think we're done at 2.
our five-year-old, you know, back when he was 2.5, you know, he was potty trained, and we're like, okay, this isn't bad, let's have another one. And then we did, and you go straight back to diapers, you stand up all night, and you're like, oh, man.
Great. It's hard being away from the family.
Oh, yeah.
Eric Cush, number 60, is battling for a roster spot with David Arkin, number 66.
Cush was better at guard than he was at center. He's playing stronger, and he's playing more confident. I think Arkin could play guard and center. This guy's smart.
All right, so who's our backup center right now? Arkin or Cush?
Both of those two guys would have to compete for the job.
Did you like Joe Montana when you were a kid?
Oh, yeah.
Man, you watch this line, man. You do a lot of things like him, man.
Sorry?
You do a lot of things like him. You really do. I mean, I got to watch him play in practice the whole time. I used to go to watch him all the time.
He's pretty good.
Yeah, he's pretty good. Yeah. He's pretty good. I just wonder when I saw the 16, I was going, you probably are.
That's why I've worn it.
Jared Goff isn't the starting quarterback. That role belongs to number 17, Case Keenum. Fact is, Goff has some work to do to beat out Sean Mannion, number 14, for the second-string job.
Sean really, I think, has had an outstanding camp. You know, I liked him as a rookie, but he's that much better now, in my opinion. I feel comfortable having to put 14 in the ballgame. Next would be Jared. I think the kid's made great strides. I believe reps are his best friend. He has the mental capacity, and I think as he continues to get more reps, it will help him.
Okay, who's two against the 49ers?
Tonight we're in the Twin Cities, the Rams and the Vikings in the exhibition finale from U.S. Bank Stadium.
Well, get him up, Dad. Turner's about to get his thing signed after the game.
He bought himself a jersey.
What's wrong with buying another man's jersey, bro? See, that's what's wrong with y'all. People got too much pride these days.
Let's go. Huh? Yeah. You all right? Come on. Shit. Hey, let's go compete, man. Let's go. You guys are going. Go. Shit. Go have fun. Let's go. Let's go. One, two, three. One, two, three. Win. Let's go, boys.
Let's go. Let's go, baby.
How much do you want to make this team? How much do you want to be a part of the Los Angeles Rams? You have to show it today.
Great day, baby. Don't let nothing hold you back here. I'm having fun with this shit.
All right, Jared, let's have a little fun. Drive these guys now, right? Thanks. One play at a time. Hey, one here.
Goff takes a clean snap on Reed, right side. It's caught by Reynolds. He shakes the first tackler at the 50. Down the near sideline into the Vikings territory. Goff in the shotgun. Picks up his off the right. He's got room to run. Goes up and fires. It's complete. At the 20, Bradley Martinez scores down inside the 5-yard line.
You're right.
Let's go.
Hey! Wants to throw near side. It is caught by Benny Fritz. Touchdown, LA.
First starting drive for Jared Goff, and he takes his Rams down the field for an opening touchdown.
Four days after his meeting with Jeff Fisher, LaMarcus Joyner is eager to prove that his coach's faith in him is justified.
LaMarcus Joyner is a very special player. To be able to cover a guy all the way across field, he was on the receiver step for step.
Ethan Westbrooks needs to impress tonight. The defensive lineman who once had his coach throw paper in his face is still on shaky ground.
Third and 12th,
The Vikings behind the chains with 5:23 to go and trailing 7-0. Straight back drop. Wanted to throw the screen left, now rolls to his right.
Get it. Come on, Ethan!
It is caught by tiptoeing Jarius Wright. Ethan Westbrook's the left defensive end. Came inside. He has to stay outside to contain the quarterback.
In preseason game number 4, any mistake could cost you a job.
What are you doing?
That's right.
You have to stay outside. Listen. Fuck. Why would you come back underneath?
Listen to me. What else did you talk about doing? The pound?
Then fucking do it.
Come on.
That's a fucking sack.
It would come right through you.
Come on.
Jared Goff was the number one pick in this year's draft. For the Rams, that makes him a potential franchise player. For the rest of the league, it just makes him a target.
Oh, fuck. He got hit again.
Down 7.
Yeah, like it's 40. Hey!